Welcome everyone to our demo today of DL Mobile. We're glad you could make it. My name is Jim Kemp, and in a moment we'll be joined by ColombiaSoft Solutions Engineer Dave Howell. Today we're going to look at the new mobile access and document locator. This was a new feature in our third major update of the year, version 6.3. To begin, we'll talk about web access in general, since mobile is a component of web tools in Document Locator. Then Dave is going to show us a demo of the new mobile interface. We'll end today with a Q&A. As I mentioned, DL Mobile is part of the web tools component in Document Locator. This is a self-hosted web access solution for your document management system that allows employees, customers, vendors, whoever you authorize to log in and retrieve files, upload files, and participate in workflows. It's an easy way for people outside the office to get what they need without having people inside the office retrieve and send files. As an alternative to email, FTP, faxing, and shipping, people save time using web access, and everything remains organized and under control inside the document management system. With the addition of mobile, people can now use their mobile smartphones and tablets in an easy-to-use, mobile-friendly interface. That's because it's engineered using HTML5 technology, and it works on Windows phones, iPhones, iPads, Androids, and even the latest generations of BlackBerry. With DL Mobile, users can open and view files, PDFs, and emails, search file content and use safe searches, send and receive notifications, and even participate and approve workflow steps. DL Mobile is, of course, just one component of the overall document management system. Our focus today is on mobile access, but if you have questions about any other areas of the system, please feel free to contact us. Now, I'd like to introduce Solutions Engineer Dave Howell, who's going to give us a demo of DL Mobile. Dave?
Thanks, Jim. And I'm going to lower the slide. And we're going to take a look at the new DL Mobile application. Before I actually show you the mobile application, I'd like to bring up our existing Document Locator Web Tools application that some of you may be familiar with already. So the mobile is really an extension and another way to get into Document Locator securely to access and work with documents. And of course, Web Tools, which we've had for quite some time as I log on here, gives you a view of the repository into different areas, into folders, and down to document levels. So Web Tools has been a great tool for collaboration, working with folks who have an internet connection and a browser. Now we're very pleased to announce that we have the new Windows mobile application for Document Locator, and I'm going to open up an emulator to have a look at that. So this is a look for any mobile, most any mobile device that's HTML5 compatible this will work with. Here's your first look at it. And basically by clicking on the documents, which I'm starting with, we can get into different document folders. We'll go back here. So we have documents. We can search. I will be showing you each of these in just a moment. We can get messages, and really nice, we can get the workflow tasks will come in here, and we can look at the documents or document and actually the task to approve documents, for instance. We can look at project documents, and we have an online help system as well. Let's go back and take a look at documents. So this just lets you drill down into various folder levels, again, that you have rights to drill into. Here I'm going to go ahead and I'll open up one of our folders to get down to a document view. You would just do touch on your mobile device. Here we're down to a document level, so we can display all your different document types in Document Locator Mobile. So when I click on this one now, what we're going to do is show you that the attributes about the document. And when you scroll down, we can actually now view this document. And so here's an example of the expense statement that we have. And we'll go back. We can also, on this document, if we needed to notify somebody, we can hit on the notification tab. Type in the person that you'd like to notify about a particular document. It'll bring a user selectable list for you. It'll have a link to the related files. You can type your message here as needed. Then you can send off the document for a notification with a link to it. And what's also important is even from the mobile, you can initiate a document or documents into a workflow. So you can come down onto the workflow tab, click on that, and actually put a document into a workflow. Here in this case, it will have a link to the expense report that we might want to approve. We can select the different route. Maybe we want to do an approval of the given routes that we have rights to. We can put in a message as needed. And then we can go OK, and that'll go into a workflow for approval. So taking a step back here, so there's some things you can do when you get into a document level. What's also interesting is we've added a feature right here where you can do multiple selects from a search or from a document folder level in this example. So perhaps I wanted to send the budget document, the capital request, and the purchase order document. I can select all of these and put all of these into a workflow with links to those documents to review for approval or editing as needed. So we can back up or we can go back onto the home button or to any of the elements in mobile that we have here across the top bar. Next thing I wanted to show you is search. When I click on search, you have these different attributes that you can search on. Here I've selected full text and file names. I can also search notes and property values. We'll come up here and just put in some of the attributes that we want to search for. Here we might want to go in and search for, we'll say maybe maybe we'll search for an audit report. And you just, you know, tap on your mobile device as needed. We'll look for some reports. And so I can kick off this search by hitting search, or I could just hit my enter on my keypad on my mobile device. So we'll kick off the search there. It's found the two documents that met that criteria. As we mentioned, we can select that document, review the attributes, view, notify, put it into a workflow, things that we showed you previously. This will let you back up, to modify your search, multiple select as needed. Another nice thing about the search is that you can also have access to the saved searches that you have rights to. So we'll have different search folders, searches here. Here's just a simple search that we want to initiate for all the Excel files out in the system from a saved search. So saved searches and searching for attributes are available. The next thing is that we have messages that come in. So these are messages that are coming right in to Document Locator to notify you about certain things. For instance, here's a court notification, and we can go through and look at the notification message, also reference the document that's related, and we can come down here and we can reply, forward, or delete, or hit OK that we've acknowledged that record, for instance. Very important are the tasks now. It's nice you can be out on the road or traveling and be able to review documents for approval. So here we have a task. We're asked to review this document right here. These are the workflow tasks that have been assigned to us. So if we need to review this document, we click on it. I want to review this employee report. I can scroll through, have a look at that report. Check my instructions out, any task information, step instructions, review the step instructions for the users, be sure all the users are on there. Double check any route instructions, review this, and here's some route messages. Please check the list for correct names. So I have everything here that I can expand out. Once I've reviewed it, in this case, I can say that the task is complete. Or if this was an approval task, I could say that I would approve or reject. And here I'll say I've completed the task. I can put a comment as needed, simply hit OK, and that will have reached a review status for that particular step. The other thing that we have here besides tasks is if you're working with projects, which a project will be a collection of different documents in different areas in the repository that you're managing at a project version level. So we can actually come in and see under our campaign project, even though these documents may be in different areas of Document Locator, we have them rolled into these projects that we can manage. Again, the things we've shown you all apply from the projects module as well. The other thing with Document Locator, of course, you can log out, authenticate back in with your credentials, info about the device that you're working with, and we have a very nice online help system accessing Document Locator, so you'll see a complete help system here. We'll just open one of these up to show you the time that we've spent to help you here on the mobile device if you need additional information about how that would work for you. So basically that's a quick overview of a Document Locator mobile, and we're going to open our PowerPoint slide back up, and we'll turn this back over to Jim.
Thank you, Dave. That was a great demo. Before we begin the Q&A session, I'd like to mention that for existing customers on support and maintenance, upgrades to version 6.3 are available at no additional charge. Our support and maintenance program includes free upgrades. If you are on the maintenance program, check out the upgrades section of ColumbiaSoftConnect.com. Now, let's begin the Q&A. If we don't get to your question today, we'll follow up with you directly after the event. First question is there an iPhone app?
Yeah, with Document Locator Mobile, we didn't write a specific app to the iPhone or the Android or the Windows phone. We developed it in HTML, so it runs HTML5, so it runs the same across all of those devices. And we fully tested it on iPhone, iPad, Android, and even the new BlackBerry phones. So what we showed you was from a Windows phone emulator, but it works just the same under the iPhone.
The next question is, what are the technical requirements to install web tools and DL Mobile?
Yeah, for DL Mobile to run, we need to be sure you have web tools installed. And web tools simply installs on the Microsoft IIS server as part of the web tools installation. And then from there, the mobile app can be enabled, and the administration of that can be done through the web tools administration also. But you would need the web tools on the Internet Information Services.
Next question is this webinar being recorded so we can watch it later? And the answer to that is yes, we will have a recording available for customers on ColumbiaSoftConnect.com, and we will also provide a link to those registered here today. Next question is, from mobile devices, will users need to click the web tools link versus the D-Link attachment to approve workflow notifications?
Yeah, in Document Locator Mobile, users will click essentially the web tools link, which is the mobile link to access and open that document on their mobile device.
Next question is, if you don't have web tools, are you not able to use DL Mobile? And that's correct. DL Mobile is a component of the web tools for Document Locator. And so if you'd like some more information about that, feel free to give us a call, and we can explain it to you further how that licensing for the web tools web access works. Next question is, how do you count the number of concurrent users for web tools DL Mobile? And there's really no difference. Concurrent means that they're shared licenses, shared access, and DL Mobile is a component of web tools, so there's really no difference in the count. It would just be someone using a mobile interface version of web tools. Next question regards HTML5 and if web tools is now supported on Safari and Chrome browsers.
Yeah, with the actual web tools product is not all the way under HTML5 at this point. We do have customers running under those different browsers, but we're not fully supporting that until we complete the rewrite on the web tools product. However, the mobile application is a complete HTML5 application.
Another question regarding licensing and DL Mobile, is it covered under web tools? And yes, DL Mobile is a component of the Web Tools license. Next question is can you edit files into DL Mobile?
With Document Locator Mobile, is really defined been designed to view files, view them and approve them, scroll through the different files when you open them up. We don't have a checkout event, so we're not really checking the file out on the mobile device and doing the edit and versioning back into the system.
Thank you, everyone, for attending today's briefing on DL Mobile. This concludes our meeting today. Goodbye.